Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, WIT Solapur. Topic for today's session, Determination of Velocity of Flow through Sewer Line. Learning outcome of this session, student will be able to determine the velocity of flow through sewer line. Following are the empirical formula which used to determine the velocity of flow. Chase's formula, Cutter's formula, Basin's formula, Manning's formula, Crimp and Brugg's formula, Hazen and Williams formula. See first Chase's formula. Chase's gave a formula, velocity is equal to C under root of RS, where V is the velocity of flow in meter per second, S is the slope of sewer or hydraulic gradient, R is a hydraulic mean radius, it is in meter. Compute R by formula area upon perimeter, keep area in meter square, and where C is the Chase's constant. Cutter's formula, Cutter's gave the empirical formula for Chase's constant. This is a formula for Chase's constant, and in this formula there is a S, N and R. S as usual it is a gradient of sewer line, and R is the hydraulic mean radius, and the new term is N. Here N is the rugosity coefficient. The table 1 gives us the rugosity coefficient. It is also called as Manning's coefficient. The N is depend on the roughness or smoothness of the inner surface. In the table there is a list of various material and the condition of that material, whether it is in good condition or fair condition. Accordingly there is a value of N. So for value of N you refer table number 1. Number 3, Basin's formula. C is equal to 157.6 divided by 1 plus 81 plus K upon under root of R. This is Basin's formula. Basin's also gave us Chase's constant C, where K is the Basin's constant, and in table 2, chart for K. Here again there is a type of surface, various type of surface, and this is a guideline for the value of K. Number 4, Manning's formula. It is Manning's gave us formula for velocity. Velocity is equal to 1 by N R to the power 2 by 3 into S to the power 1 by 2, where R is the hydraulic mean radius and S is the slope of the sewer, same as Chase's formula. And N is the rugosity coefficient, that is nothing but the we have seen in table number 1. You refer table 1 for this value. Number 5 empirical formula is Crimp and Brugg's formula, where V is equal to 83.47 into R to the power 2 by 3 into S to the power 1 by 3. It is similar to Manning's formula if the value of 1 by N is equal to 83.47. It is similar to Manning's formula. There's a little difference in formula given by Hazen's and Williams. Formula is V is equal to 0.85 into C, R to the power 0.63 into S to the power 0.54. Here there's a new parameter C. C is the Hazen's and Williams coefficient, and in table 3, the value of Hazen and Williams coefficient C is given. You refer the formula. There are various types of material. With respect to that material, there is a value of C. Take one example. In this example, a sewer of 0.6 meter diameter laid at a gradient of 1 in 400 runs full. Using Crimp and Brugg's formula, determine velocity of flow and the discharge. So, Crimp's and Brugg's formula is 83.47 into R to the power 2 by 3 into S to the power 1 by 2. So, let us find first R. R is the hydraulic mean radius, and it is calculated by area by perimeter. So, what area we have to consider? It is given that sewer having diameter, means it is circular in section and it runs full. So, area of that sewer is pi d square by 4. And perimeter is 2 pi r, that is pi d. So as it is area and perimeter we consider because it run full. So r is equal to a by p, put a and p in the formula, it will come d by 4. So r is d by 4. So calculate it, d by 4 comes 0.15 meter. Put r and s in the formula of velocity, v is equal to 1.178 meter per second. Now calculate discharge. Discharge is equal to area into velocity. Here the sewer run full, so consider whole area, that is pi d square by 4, and into velocity that we have 1.178. So discharge is equal to 0.333 meter cube per second. You can calculate it in liter per second, that is 333 liter per second. Now you pause video here for a minute and write answer of the question. What is the hydraulic mean radius of circular section sewer running half full? Here is the answer. Formula for hydraulic mean radius is area upon perimeter. It is running half full, so consider half of area, that is half of pi d square by 4. And also consider perimeter, half of the total section, that is pi d by 2. Put the values of area and perimeter in the formula of r, it come again d by 4. So when sewer run full, hydraulic radius is d by 4, and when sewer run half full, then also r is equal to d by 4. Take one example. Determine the velocity of flow and discharge in a sewer of circular section having diameter 1 meter laid at a gradient of 1 in 500. Use Manning's formula. Take n is equal to 0.012. Assume that sewer is running half full. Manning's formula is velocity is equal to 1 by n r to the power 2 by 3 and s into s to the power 1 by 2. We have seen when sewer run half full, hydraulic mean radius is d by 4. So diameter by 4, it is 1 by 4 is equal to 0.25. And n is given to you. If it is not given, you can refer the chart. N is equal to 0.012. And the gradient of sewer line is given 1 in 500. Put all the values in our formula, v is equal to 1 by n into r to the power 2 by 3 into s to the power 1 by 2. After putting all the values in formula, we get velocity is equal to 1.479 meter per second. Find out discharge. As we know, discharge is equal to area into velocity. But here, sewer is running half full. So consider half of the area. So pi d square by 8, it is the half of the area. Into velocity we have 1.479. So discharge will get 0.581 meter cube per second or 581 liter per second. These are my references. Thank you.